Good evening and welcome to a new quick edit video. This time I want to edit a morning scene from a lake and also do a little focus checking on this shot because as you can see the background is sharp but the foreground isn't, so I've shot a little sequence with different focus points and the focus checking I will be doing later in Photoshop, but first let's check out the before and after images. So I guess I'm applying a vintage style effect on this picture. So first let me just activate the lens correction settings. Then I'm going all the way down to the calibration tab and do some little color grading just to get those vintage colors you probably know from a lot of Instagram pictures. So for this I want to increase red and green primary hues. And then I want to turn down the blue primary hues a little bit. And as you can see in the before and after, the image already has this kind of orange teal effect on it. Okay, then back to the top. I also need to choose a different camera profile. Therefore, I am clicking on the grid and then go to the vintage tab. And I guess I'm going with the second preset here. That looks rather nice. And I also need to adjust the white balance. I think I want to make this image a little bit warmer, so I'm increasing the temperature. And I also want to add some tint. Then it's time for the basic adjustments. Basically, I want to increase the highlights a little bit. And the whites. And I also want to crush the blacks a little bit. That means I'm bringing them up. And next I want to apply some clarity and as well as some vibrance and a saturation. I also want to do some local adjustments on this image, but not too much. I already have applied two radial filters. The first one is just here for the fog in the middle part of the image, which I want to make a little bit stronger. Therefore, I'm increasing the clarity all the way up, and you can already see it's getting way more visible. I also want to reduce the dehaze, which adds a little bit more haze. And then I also want to increase the whites just a little bit. Then the second radial filter is just to add some glow to this area in the sky. And for this one, I'm just increasing the blacks all the way up. And that was it for the local adjustments. Then I want to play around with the tone curve. Basically, I want to further crush the blacks. Therefore, I'm picking the black point in the bottom left corner. And I just drag it up a little bit. And to add some contrast, I'm going to apply a point relatively in the middle of this. And I could also add another point on the darker side of this. So just to add some more contrast. Next, I'm working on the color grading again. I guess I'm increasing the orange and yellow color saturation for this shot. And I want to reduce the blue ones. Then I want to go on with the split toning. And of course, for the highlights, I'm choosing a nice warm color and decrease the strength. And then for the shadows, I'm applying a colder color. And again, decrease the strength. And then lastly, I want to sharpen the image. Then I have to apply those settings to all the other shots from this sequence. So I have selected them all and then I'm just pressing the sync button and synchronize the shots. And then it's time to open them up in Photoshop. Okay, now I have placed all the images in one Photoshop file, as you can see. And the first thing I need to do is to align them all. So I'm selecting them all and go to Edit and Auto Align Layers. And just press OK. And once that is done, again, I'm going to Edit and then Auto Blend Layers and Stack Images. And again, press OK. And as you can see, I pretty much messed up the focus stacking. But that's only partly my fault because The day I was shooting this, there was a lot of wind going on, and so all those plants you can see in the foreground weren't at the same place for the different pictures I took. So I guess I need to continue without the focus stacking. I'm really sorry for that, but at least you were able to see the focus stacking process. I'm sorry for that. I guess I'm just going with this picture as it has a nice sharp background and still a kind of interesting foreground. So let's see if I can add any further effects with the Nik collection to make this picture more interesting. And I think right at the start I want to choose the polarization filter and give this image a little bit more saturation. Okay, I like that look. Let's see if I can add some more local glow. Therefore I'm applying a new layer again and then change the blending mode to soft light. And with the eyedropper tool I'm choosing a warm color from the sky area and change back to the brush tool. And let's see where I can add some glow here. Okay, I think that looks good, but I still need to adjust the opacity a little bit. And I think that's it for editing this image. I'm really sorry that I messed up the focus stacking, but I guess you get the idea of the whole process. So thank you very much for watching this video, and if you'd like to see more content like this, then please feel free to subscribe to my channel.